Facebook, MySpace, High Five, Bieber, Twitter, Facebook.
I know many of you are on Facebook, MySpace, Twitter. Social networking sites. Experts say it's a growing trend.
I think my idea of social networking is actually people meeting in pubs or in clubs or going around having a drink. That's my idea of social networking.
I think social networking is like just a way of people connecting around the world, gaining information, sharing information, you know, receiving information, doing business on it, you know. There's so many things that can be done on social networking.
I would say meeting new people, socializing, catching up with your old friends, like Lost Links, event organizing. It helps with regards to promotion, finding what events are going on. You know, just it's just like another world, and you're just, you know, having insight into that other world.
About communication between people, communication between everybody all around the world, and without any rules of all boundaries.
A cyber network whereby people take the real world to the internet.
Your tally, your visible tally of friends, and that's the adrenaline rush. That's what's so scary, is that you realise that people are joining your list, you want more friends, and you find yourself casting around for spurious people that you...
Some people have like 2,000 friends there.
Obviously, there is a clear difference between a virtual friend and a friend in real life.
It's a great way to keeping score, put it that way, of how many people you've met.
When it comes to friends and social networking, I don't know how it is with other people, but myself, I can say that people that I don't know in person, and I just have them as friends on some social network, they are not such real people as the people I know.
As to Twitter, for example, the more followers you have, sometimes shows you've either been using that site for a long time, or you just tweet interesting things. People find you interesting enough to follow you. Whereas with Facebook, you don't really have to be that interesting to get many friends.
So I don't think it matters how many people you know on Facebook. What matters is who you truly know, face to face.
What benefits do I gain from social networking?
I would say it's the keeping in touch with friends and people that are far away, because myself, I don't live in my home country. I moved over to a different country, which is like 3,000 kilometers away from where I lived usually before, originally, where all my friends, I left them all there behind, and my family and basically everyone I ever knew. So it helps me to keep in touch, and that's the main benefit, that I can still, you know, know the newest gossips.
Yeah, I've made a bit of money from social networking, from promoting events and like saying good causes. Made a few friends through social networking, a few good contacts. Once got a job through social networking, you know. Messaged a guy I network with on Facebook, and he actually gave me a job. So you can see I've gained quite a few positive benefits from social networking, which I'm quite happy about.
Benefits that I've received personally from internet social networking, I can only honestly identify one, which would be from Facebook, which is linking up with family members that are abroad and meeting up with people I used to go to school with. But apart from that, I don't really believe there is much benefit in internet social networking.
Social networking?
I don't think I can.
Yeah, I think I can.
Nowadays, I don't think you can survive without going online.
Totally hooked up on it.
Become a part of my life somehow. It's not very good, but it has become a part of my life.
Do I think I could survive without it? I could, because it wasn't there in the beginning.
Because that's how you get connected nowadays.
But in terms of contact learning, which is not social networking website, but it's part of the social networking plan, I don't think I could or would like to be about my bed. I remember when it dropped in the shower and I've done CPR on my phone. I really don't think I could do without it, to be honest.
I don't know what the future holds for. I think I'm pretty pessimistic. I don't think this civilization will last long. I think in 20 years there will be no civilization. The economy will is doomed. That's what I think. But hey, I don't know. We survived this long. But yeah, if there is an internet in 20 years, I think we'll be even worse. I think we'll have chips in our heads and talk to people. Like now, we see people on the street talking to themselves, we think, but they're on their phone. So yeah, in the future, I think we'll just have a chip in our head and be on Facebook while we're walking down the street. And our eyes will be at the screen. And yeah, I think there is a future for it, yeah. Nowadays, we won't survive without it.
So when you look at it from that point of view, you can see that the future is basically limitless. If you're really into it and you know what you're doing, it can take you as far as you want. I mean, there's also dangers involved in it, you know, but I like to look at the positive side of things, and I think social networking has a very bright future ahead of it.
About you every day.